Hello friends, today we are going to start the topic private cloud computing, in which we are going to learn about private cloud, its advantages, disadvantages, securing, etc. Private cloud. Private cloud describes an on-demand cloud deployment model where cloud computing services and infrastructure are hosted privately within a company's own intranet or data center using proprietary resources. The company oversees the management, maintenance, and operation of the private cloud. A company that wishes to use cloud computing services may choose between a private cloud, where cloud services are hosted by the company, and a public cloud, where the cloud service is hosted by a provider, or a combination of the two, also known as the hybrid cloud. Private cloud. Private clouds are the cloud infrastructure based on dedicated hardware under the control of the organization, offering on demand through a self-service portal. Private cloud provides elasticity that was previously unavailable in the traditional computing models, now including rapid computer resource provisioning with the services built back to individual business units. The infrastructure services are single tenant and they can be managed by the organization or a third party, either on the premises or in the third party data centers. Private cloud can be deployed either by using one of the packaged cloud platforms like the Eucalyptus, OpenStack, or many more, etc. We can say, by adding automation management and self-provisioning capabilities to an already virtualized infrastructure. It does not matter how one deploys a private cloud, as long as it results in resources being pooled together into one centralized unit available on demand to the users to provide, provision, manage, and monitor using a management interface and a chargeback mechanism. Private clouds are useful in highly regulated industries like financial sector, healthcare, scientific computing, etc. Similarly, businesses wanted to run a legacy applications. We will find private clouds suitable for their needs. See, legacy application means the applications on which they are working presently, or they were working in the past working scenarios, or they were continuing on working on them. Now they don't want to change that particular applications and work on them particularly. So what they do is they use that particular applications and then they run it on the cloud, or they use the cloud environment so that that particular application becomes platform independent. Then it can be accessible from anywhere. It could be used by the employees. However, it should be noted that most of the workloads can be moved from public clouds by ensuring that proper security procedures are implemented. In fact, availability and business continuity offered by public clouds are comparable to those offered by private clouds. Now, for this private cloud, we have a diagram. See, this is the intranet. Intranet is within the organization or within the company. Now, that with that intranet, all these employees can access these services from the cloud. Now, this is the private cloud we have. This private cloud provides compute services, storage services, and network services within the organization. How does private cloud work? With cloud computing, instead of storing resources or data on a physical server in one location, remote servers host cloud-based servers and data. Employees can access these services or information on the company network from any location via the internet. Companies may choose to host their own private cloud that only their employees can access or use shared space on a public cloud. For the employee, the experience of using a service that is hosted in a private cloud is indistinguishable from using a public cloud or even a service that is locally hosted. Now, why one should go for a private cloud? Private cloud is a cloud computing model that is often necessary to meet specific security needs or the compliance requirement. Now, security needs or the compliance requirement means for a IT company, privacy is the most important aspect. Now, for privacy, what do they do? As the name suggests, private cloud. Private cloud is only for that particular organization or a company. The data which need not to be shared or which needs to be protected is secure in that particular cloud. Thus, for a company who wants to have its data secure, works for the private cloud or uses the private cloud. Because the owner maintains complete control over a private cloud, and not only one organization ensure tighter security, they also benefit from better availability. Now, better availability is if one has their own private cloud or one has their own private cloud infrastructure, so availability for their company is always there. They don't have to move for scalability, they don't have to move for the elasticity of that particular cloud, they don't have to pay for it more. They can scale it as per the use and they can use it as per the requirement. And now next point is the more uptime it provides for the company. These private clouds provide more uptime for a company than comparing to a public cloud, which can offer. Consequently, an organization might choose to use a private cloud for mission critical operations or sensitive data storage. Now, hosting a private cloud does not exclude using a public cloud at the same time. Means if an organization is using a private cloud, it needs to use public cloud as well. We cannot just rule out public cloud. This common configuration where a private and a public cloud coexist is known as the hybrid cloud environment. Hybrid cloud environment we are going to discuss later on. Now, types of private cloud. There are different types of private clouds that deliver different cloud services. When the companies use a private cloud for infrastructure as a service, the cloud might host storage, networking, and compute services. Private clouds can also support platform as a service or PaaS applications, which work like regular software applications that are hosted on a local computer. Then, there are also a variety of types of private clouds hosting options, including software-only platforms, combined software and hardware packages, and hosted or managed private clouds, where the private cloud server may live on the customer's premises or in a vendor's data center, but is hosted and sometimes managed by a vendor. Some public cloud service providers also offer virtual public clouds, which create small isolated environments for the specific users. Now, what is virtual private cloud? First one, see, virtual private cloud, they are different from conventional private clouds because the resources in a virtual private cloud exist in a walled off area of a public cloud instead of being hosted on premises. Now, what does that mean? That means we are using a public cloud. But in a public cloud, we are not creating a physical infrastructure for that particular company. But a company needs a private cloud. So what it does is, it uses that particular public cloud. Now, in that particular public cloud, what does a company do is, they use that particular physical resources, create a private cloud out of it, virtual private cloud out of it, for that, or you can say that shared pool of resources is being used by a particular company only and not by the other, or not shared by the other companies. Thus, we are using public cloud itself, but to some extent, that particular area is walled off and is being used by a particular firm itself. The above list categorizes private clouds by the way they are hosted and to what extent they are managed by the provider. They can also be categorized by the types of infrastructure they provide. For example, softwares only provides only the software necessary running the private cloud environment, which runs on an organization's pre-existing hardware. That means no new hardware is being installed for that. A software-only option is often utilized in highly virtualized environments. Software and hardware. Some vendors sell private clouds as an all-in-one bundle of hardware and software. It is generally a simple platform that exists on the user's premises and may or may not be provider-managed environments. That means the cloud or the hardware and the software is in the user's, or you can say the customer's, premise and not on the premises of the cloud service provider. Hosted private cloud is the next type of cloud computing, or we can say private cloud computing. In hosted private cloud, a type of private cloud that is hosted by a separate cloud service provider on premises or in a data center, but the server is not shared with any other organizations. That means the private cloud which is present or which a company is using is not in the user's premises or in the company's premises, customer's premises. It is in the premise of the data service or data center provider. But it is only dedicatedly assigned to that particular organization which is using it, or it is assigned for a service to the organization for a particular service, or an organization can only access that particular cloud. Now, the cloud service provider is responsible for configuring the network and maintaining the hardware for the private cloud, as well as keeping the software updated. The options provide the best of both worlds for organizations who require the security and availability of a private cloud, but prefer not to invest in an in-house data center. That means the particular organization don't want to get into the responsibility of maintaining a complete data center. Thus, it has accessed or availed the services of a data center from a particular service provider. Now, the third type of private cloud is the managed private cloud. In managed private cloud, a step up from a hosted private cloud, although the two terms are sometimes used interchangeably. With a managed private cloud, a cloud service provider not only hosts a private cloud for an organization, but it also manages and monitors the day-to-day operations of the private cloud. The cloud service provider may also deploy and update additional cloud-based services such as storage and identity management for service audits. A managed private cloud can save a company's considerable time and IT resources. This means that if a company do not want to invest into that particular infrastructure, it is giving it to a service provider who is managing that particular cloud for the company. Now, what does it do? The major effect, or you can say the major benefit that a particular company has, is it saves a time and the resources in which it has to invest. Benefits of private cloud. Total system control, resulting in a stronger security, is the first benefit of cloud computing. Private cloud computing. A private cloud offers total system control and increased security through dedicated hardware and physical infrastructure that's used exclusively by the company that owns it. Now, the next point is the greater performance. What does greater performance means here is the, because the hardware is dedicated and not used by any other organization. That means it is dedicated to that one particular organization. Workload performance for cloud services is never affected by another company running resources or another company running resource-intensive workloads on a shared server by a public cloud service outage. Third point is long-term cost savings. Now, what does long-term cost saving means here is, while it can be expensive to set up infrastructure, it is obviously expensive to set up a complete infrastructure for our company. A complete cloud infrastructure costs much more. So, to support a private cloud, if an organization already has a hardware and network required for hosting a private cloud, can be much more cost-effective long-term compared to paying monthly fees to use someone else's server on a public cloud. Next point is scalability. Now, what does scalability mean here is, if an organization outgrows its existing hardware resources, it can easily add more. If the growth is temporary or seasonal, an organization can move to a hybrid cloud, incurring minimal usage fees by using the public cloud only when necessary. We can once again go through this point is scalability. Now, scalability is if an organization outgrows its existing hardware resources means the hardware resources which is already existing with the organization. But now for scalability, what it has to do is it has to increase that hardware so that it can increase its strength and the usability, availability for the employees or the users. So what it can do is it can easily add more. Now, if the growth is temporary or seasonal, an organization can move to a hybrid cloud. What is hybrid cloud? Hybrid cloud here means a combination of public plus private cloud. See, now the scalability, or we can say the usage, is not permanent. That means you are not going to increase always. You need it for a temporary purpose. So what you can do is you can use your own private cloud plus some of the services from the public cloud as well. And combination of these two gives us the hybrid cloud. This is the solution which is incurring minimal usage fees by using public cloud only when necessary. Next point is predictable cost. In predictable cost, in addition, the cost of using a public cloud can be very unpredictable. Unpredictable here means like the pricing, how much a service provider can charge us. For example, we are using the Dropbox services, we are using the Google Drive services. 25 GB of this space is given free. Now, after 25 GB, if you extend the use, you do not know how much the service provider is going to charge. Sometimes, if you are not using more than 5 GB or 5 MB, the pricing is variable. But if you are using more than that, you do not know how much amount of the price or what is the cost a particular service provider is going to charge. That is why it is considered as unpredictable. But with a private cloud, costs are same each month. That means you know you have to pay that particular amount of money to that service provider. This much amount of services we are using, and for that particular service we are paying, regardless of the workload an organization is running. Next point is better customization. Now, better customization means since the companies have complete control of a private cloud, it is much easier to reallocate resources and tailor the cloud to perform specifically according to the requirements that the company defines. IT managers have access to every levels of setting in their private cloud environment. They are not limited by policies set by public cloud service providers. Next comes the private cloud economics. Now, private cloud economic means one of the biggest misconceptions about private cloud is that private cloud will save money. No, it can and often does, but it does not inherently do it or inherently do so. The upfront cost can be considerable. For example, automation technology, an important part of private cloud network, can be a significant investment for many IT organizations. The result can be the ability to reallocate resources more efficiently, and it allows some organization to reduce their overall capital expenditure for the new hardware, which can also save money. But overall, savings are not assured. Gartner analysts say that the primary driving benefit of adopting a private cloud model should not be cost saving, but rather increased agility, dynamic scalability, which can improve time to market for business that make the use of technology. Next point is, private cloud can be in the public cloud. Many people associate private cloud with being located in an organization's private on-premise data center, and public cloud is coming from a third-party service provider. But NIST notes, NIST is the organization that is National Institute for Standards and Technology. It notes, while a private cloud may be owned, managed, and operated by a private organization, its infrastructure may be located off-premises. Many providers sell off-premises private clouds, meaning that while the physical resources are located in a third-party facility, but they are dedicated to a single customer and not to any other one. They are not shared. They are in public cloud with multi-tenant pooling of resources among multiple customers. Private cloud computing is defined by privacy, not location, ownership, or management responsibility, says the Gartner analyst Tom Bittman. When dealing with cloud providers, be wary of security definitions. Some vendors may, for example, outsource their data center operations to a co-location facility where they might not dedicate hardware to each customer. Or they could pool resources among customers, but say they guarantee privacy by separate them using VPNs. Investigate the details of off-premises private cloud offerings. Private cloud is more than infrastructure as a service. How? Infrastructure as a service is the big reason for adopting private cloud architectures, but it is by no means is only usefulness. Software and platform as a service are also important. Though Bittman says infrastructure as a service is the fastest growing segment, infrastructure as a service only provides the lowest level data center resources in an easy to consume way and does not fundamentally change how IT is done. Platform as a service is where organizations can create customized applications built to run on a cloud infrastructure. Platform as a service comes in public or private flavors as well, having the application development service hosted either in an on-premises data center or in a dedicated environment from a provider. Private cloud is not always private. How? Private cloud is the natural first step toward a cloud network for many organizations. It provides access to the benefits of the cloud. Now here, benefits means the agility, scalability, efficiency, without some of the security concerns, perceived or real, that come with using the public cloud. But Bittman predicts that as the cloud market continues to evolve, organizations will open to the idea of using public cloud resources. Service level agreements and security precautions will mature, the impact of outages and downtime will be minimized. That means we can get more uptime using the public cloud as well. Eventually, Gartner predicts the majority of private cloud deployments will become hybrid clouds, meaning they will leverage the public cloud resources. Meaning, your private cloud today may be the hybrid cloud tomorrow. By starting with a private cloud, IT is positioning itself as the broker of all services for the enterprise, whether they are private, public, hybrid, or traditional. As private cloud evolves to hybrid or even public cloud, retain ownership of the self-service and therefore the customer and the interface. This is the part of the vision for the future of IT that we call hybrid IT or hybrid information technology. Now, advantages of private cloud. In advantages of private cloud, the first one is private cloud is that users don't share resources. The main advantage of a private cloud is that users don't share resources. Second is, because of the proprietary nature, a private cloud computing model is best for businesses with dynamic, unpredictable computing needs that require direct control over their environments, typically to meet security, business governance, or regulatory compliance requirements. When an organization properly architects, implements a private cloud, it can provide most of the same benefits found in the public clouds, such as user self-service, scalability, as well as the ability to provision and configure virtual machines and change or optimize computing resources on demand. An organization can also implement chargeback tools to track computing usage, ensure business units pay only for the resources or services they use. In addition to these core benefits, inherent to both cloud deployment models, private clouds also offer increased security of an isolated network, increased performance due to resources being solely dedicated to one organization, and increased capability for customization. Next is disadvantages of private cloud. Private cloud can also have some disadvantages. Some of them are, first, private cloud technologies such as increased automation and user self-service can bring some complexity to an enterprise. Next one is, these technologies typically require an IT team to re-architect some of its data center infrastructure as well as adopt additional management tools. Then next is, as a result, an organization might have to adjust to even increase its IT staff to successfully implement a private cloud. They can also be expensive. Often when a business owns its private cloud, it bears all the acquisition, deployment, support, and maintenance costs involved. Hosted private clouds, while not outright owned by the user, can also be costly. The service provider takes care of the basic network, maintenance, and configuration in a hosted deployment, which means the user needs to subscribe and pay regularly for that offered service. This can end up being more expensive than the upfront cost of complete ownership in the long run and sacrifices some of the control over maintenance that complete ownership guarantees. Although users will still be operating in a self-tenant environment, providers are likely serving multiple clients and promising each of them a catered custom environment. If an incident occurs on the provider's end, an improperly maintained or overburdened server, for example, users may find themselves facing the same problems of public cloud presence, that is, unreliability and lack of control. Securing cloud computing systems. A private cloud hosts one enterprise as a user. Various departments may be present in the cloud, but all are in the same enterprise. Private clouds often employ virtualization within an enterprise's existing computing servers to improve computer utilization. A private cloud also includes provisioning and metering facilities that enable fast deployment and removal where applicable. This model is similar to the conventional IT outsourcing models, but can exist as an enterprise internal delivery model also. A variety of private cloud implementations have emerged. Dedicated private cloud. Now, what is dedicated private cloud? These are hosted within a customer-owned data center or at a co-location facility operated by internal IT departments. That means dedicated private cloud, dedicated, what we mean is, it is only for that particular organization and not anyone else. It exists in the premises of that that organization itself. It is managed by that organization, the internal IT departments. It manages all the things of that particular cloud. Thus, it is dedicated to that organization. Next is community private cloud. These are located at the premises of a third party, owned, managed, and operated by the vendor, who is bound by customer service level agreements and contractual clauses with security and compliance requirements. Community private cloud is for a community. For example, the IT firms which are working on the similar type of work or similar type of service platforms, they need a particular cloud service for them. So, since these organizations work for a similar type of cause or they have a similar type of work, they can use a particular cloud. That means they can form a community and then they can own that particular private cloud, which is for their own community. Thus, a community private cloud is restricted to those organizations only. Next is managed private cloud. In managed private cloud or in this implementation, the infrastructure is owned by the customer and management is performed by a third party. That means for any organization, the cloud infrastructure is present in their own premises, but it is not maintained by that organization. It is maintained by a third party or a cloud service provider. Major private cloud vendors. A private cloud is commonly deployed on premises in much the same way a business world would build and operate its own traditional data center. However, an increasing number of vendors offer private cloud services that can bolster or even replace on-premises systems. Some of the largest players in private cloud market include: first one is the Hewlett Packard Enterprises, or we can say HPE, offers Helion Cloud Suite software, Helion Cloud Suite system hardware, Helion managed private cloud and managed virtual private cloud services. Next is the VMware. VMware enables virtualization with its vSphere product and offers its vRealize suite, cloud management platform and cloud foundation software defined data center platform for private clouds. Next is Dell EMC, offers virtual private cloud services as well as cloud management and cloud security softwares. Another one is Oracle. Oracle offers its private cloud appliance X8, which enables compute and storage capabilities optimized by private cloud deployment. Another one is IBM. IBM offers private cloud hardware along with the IBM cloud managed services, cloud security tools, cloud management and orchestration tools. Next is Red Hat. Red Hat offers private cloud deployment and management with a range of platforms including OpenStack and Gluster Storage as well as Red Hat Cloud Suite for management and deployment. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned to eKira. Subscribe to eKira.